What's up, guys? It has been a while. I haven't been on YouTube in a while. Work's been crazy. It's been nuts. But Marissa and I are going on a trip up to St. Louis. We're going to see Paramore. We're going to bring you guys along with it, kind of do like a vlog thing. We're going to do a lot of other stuff, too. Our concert isn't till Sunday, I believe. So we've got Friday night, which is today, and then all day tomorrow, and then Sunday. So, yeah, we'll bring you guys along. It'll be fun. We'll do some cool stuff and hopefully get some cool footage. So we're gonna head out, get on the road, and we'll see you guys in the next clip. Show you guys a little bit of it. This is the kitchen. There's Marissa. Here is the living room everywhere with our crap we're unpacking, getting it put everywhere, but it's really neat. We have an upstairs, show you guys that later, downstairs, but it's just like a boiler room. So we're trying to find out somewhere to eat. We're thinking Tucker's Place, they have steaks, so we're looking at that. Possibly gonna go to the Union Station. We're not 100% sure what we're gonna do yet, because we're just kind of winging this part of it. And gonna go from there. So we're pretty stoked. I'll try to bring this along if I can. If not, I'll get some pictures and stuff on my phone as well, you guys know, and I'll drop them in here. Pretty cool setup in the kitchen. I'll take you guys outside real quick. Marissa's looking up where Tucker's Place is, but we got a side door here. This is kind of our alleyway, and then across from us is the firehouse, station 11, I think. So you guys know that's gonna be what Colin's watching when he's here. He gonna hear him go out and get all stoked and everything, as always. See if we can see it from the window, because Marissa showed me earlier.
Yeah, it's right over there, that building.
I think she's got some info. You have info on where we're going or how far it is? Oh, we're going to go to eat some steak, have some fun, and yeah. Try to bring this along if I can. If I can't take it in, you know, I'll have my phone, take some pictures, show you guys what we do. We'll see you guys later. Heading to Union Station, and we're going to go to the aquarium, I think, maybe. Play some mini golf, maybe. I told her I'm gonna kick her butt at mini golf. We got a bet, going. We're gonna do that first thing. I wanna go on the Ferris wheel. Heights don't bother me. I don't know if they bother her. We're gonna do it.
They do, but I would like to do it.
Hey, look at these. There's Chucky dolls on top of that car. Right here coming at us. Oh shit. I'm going to zoom in for you guys on that one. Chucky and Chucky's bride. He what? We believe he was smoking a doobie. So you guys probably can't see. Probably can't see us too much. But I had to use my phone light. It's dark. We went on the Ferris wheel. I didn't take my GoPro because I didn't know if I could. Turns out I could have. They're having some kind of like red carpet thing here too, so like everybody had cameras and stuff, but I didn't know, so I didn't take it. But I got my phone, got some video, played putt putt golf. Pretty sure I beat Marissa. We got the ticket here. I'll have to, or we got the scorecard here. I'll have to add everything up and let you guys know here in a second, so stay tuned. Score is I won by like 10 points. I was 43 and she was 53, so dead 10 points. That's crazy. We were tying on a lot of the holes, like as in number and hits we had as well. So that's pretty crazy. What is up, guys? And good morning. It is day two. So it is Saturday, July 29th, 2023. I am gearing up to go on a run downtown St. Louis. Or I don't know if I'll get over to downtown because where we're at, but I mean, general area. So yeah, that's what I'm getting ready to do. Got to get all my stuff together, sunglasses. Aftershock earbuds, but they're not really earbuds, they're just outside the ear, all that junk, and then we're gonna head out. I'll try to get some video on my phone, but I'm not gonna take the GoPro. I do have a vest thing to wear that holds a GoPro, but I'm not comfortable wearing that, and I feel like I look like a goob, so we're just gonna use a phone. We'll see you guys out there. We'll be right back.
one. We got in 4.15 miles, 4250. I didn't know the area, so I was going kind of slow. Had to cross streets, stuff like that, so it was pretty cool. Thanks for coming over. I'll see you guys in the next one.
1-800-DROP-THE-DOLLAR.
Dude, check this out, okay? I can't say that because it sounds discrimination, but I'm a manly man. This is my wallet, all right, you know? I'm a firefighter, fire wallet. Anyway, it's bulky, and I wanted to carry something smaller, and I didn't think of it ahead of time, so Marissa had this, like, a lanyard thing that goes around your neck, and so it's gray, and it looks kind of girly, and it's not sparkly, I promise. It's just straight gray. There's no sparkles. It's just leather. Just don't be hating. But, yeah, that's what I'm carrying my license and money in, because, yeah. So, yeah. As far we're gonna go out, probably get breakfast. I'm not too hungry, so I don't know if I'll eat anything, but we will get pictures of what Marissa eats and post on Instagram. I went on a 4-mile run, as you guys know, through town. Didn't really go out with a plan. I had mapped my run, but I didn't even use it. I just went out and just zigzagged around. Really cool streets, found an old church, came across the chicken eating on a sidewalk. I kid you not. I got video of it all on my phone, so we will drop it in here, but we're gonna figure out what we're gonna do, and we'll see you guys at the next stop. So hope you guys are having a great day. Day 2, vacation. Tomorrow, day 3, we got something really cool. You guys already know if you watched my earlier videos. Anyway, see you guys at the next stop. So we tried to go to Roosters. We went to both locations. They both had like a 45 minute wait. The first one we kind of walked to, we didn't put enough time on the meter to stay pretty much. And we got things we want to do today, so we're gonna try First Watch now for breakfast and see how it is. Pretty cool, seeing some cool stuff, great experience. Hopefully I can bring you guys into some places we go to and stuff. So I'm gonna try to do that today. So we'll see you when we're eating or wherever we go. To go for now to the Cheesecake Factory because we love it. We've been there before. It's great food and we want some cheesecake. I didn't get cheesecake last time. All the other places we were wanting to go to were like over an hour to 45 minutes wait because it's peak time, and we've got to eat something because like we're not okay. Like it's already 12. So we're gonna do that. No, she's not. She can't help it. Her sugar's getting low. She's got to be careful. She has to watch that so we don't want her to have any issues. And mine gets like that too if I'm not careful and running. So we're just going to play it safe and, you know, go get some food at the Cheesecake Factory. We're going to eat regular food first and then we're going to smash the cheesecake so we don't crash our sugar later. But yeah, don't know where we're going to eat out or what tonight. Might try a cool restaurant. We're going to have to sit down and talk about it and plan out the rest of our day. I know Marissa said something about she wants to go to the Holocaust Museum. Oh, I get distracted like a small kid or a squirrel. She said she wants to go to the Holocaust Museum. There's a cool bookstore that we saw that we want to go to downtown. I want to go to Lululemon because they got some really cool guy running shorts. We ate at Cheesecake Factory. It was freaking awesome. Got some pictures. It was packed as heck. Couldn't take my camera in there. Went through the mall. Didn't want to take my camera in there because they have the alarms.
Turn right onto South Brentwood Boulevard.
I didn't want to set the alarms off, so. But we did go shopping around. Got me some Nike gear. Marissa got her some shoes that she's getting shipped because they didn't have her size. Got some sunshades for running. And, of course, we acquired cheesecake from the Cheesecake Factory. We'll show you guys that later when we devour it. So, heading back to the Airbnb now. And then gonna go shop some more, look at some more places, and yeah, just have a great time. It's day 2, it's freaking awesome. Had a little bit of a hiccup earlier trying to find somewhere to eat because
onto South Brentwood Boulevard.
We're not used to parking down here and everything, and parking garages and parking meters, and we just have to find somewhere to park, and everything's going on. We were at the peak part of the day. It was nuts. I love it though. I could live in the city life. Do you think you could live in the city life?
Absolutely not.
Absolutely not. I could. It'd take me a little bit to get used to it. I enjoy it. Like, I don't want to go home. So, yeah, it stormed while we were in the mall. I actually got, like, a severe thunderstorm warning or something. Didn't hear no thunder, though. Check this out. This is the paranormal circus everybody's
go
been talking
past
about.
This light. Then at the next one, turn left.
I've been seeing it on Facebook before we even came up here. I didn't pay any attention to where it was. Well, it's right there next to the Cheesecake Factory in the mall.
Oh, there's the city boundary. That's what that lady was talking about.
Yeah, what have been there, I wonder.
A bunch of food places. She said, I think there was a golf in there too.
We can check it out.
She said it was pretty cool.
Yeah, I see.
Good outlet. Cool. I'd be shopping there.
Hold on, you're good, you're good.
Oh, I know she here, so yeah, I gotta slow down.
I caught that on camera. We just hydroplaned a little bit. Car in front of us hit it, you couldn't see it. It's like under one of these bridges. Smack that crap. Marissa handled it like a pro though. Pull him over, son.
That's just down here. Is where y'all living at right now.
We didn't realize we're on the map, like it shows it bigger, like she was just saying. I don't know if you guys caught that. And it doesn't show, it shows stuff farther off than it actually is. So, like, honestly, tomorrow when I go on my run in the morning, I think I'm gonna get up earlier. I'm gonna go run downtown. We're almost back to our Airbnb right now. We're passing the farmer's market. I would like to go to it, but it's not open today either. Maybe it is a little bit. I don't know. Yeah. There's a few, but it's raining, so they're not banging open like crazy. I got a funny story. We were at this gas station, this one right here, last night, and we pulled up, and there was like, and I'm not racist at all, there's this Arabic dude in there, right? And then this colored lady walks in. She said, what's up to him, you know, and he said, what's up? And he didn't say nothing for a little bit, you know, and he was talking to some other people, and not in Arabic, but he had an Arabic accent. And then after he realized who she was and she got by, he like, stop, Shawty, stop. Freaking lost it. Nice guy though. We're going back downtown with the big buildings and all the junk. We're going to Left Bank Books. We're gonna hit some bookstores and stuff. We're book nuts anyway. That's what I'm gonna call us. We're book nuts. We're book nerds. And so we're gonna hit some cafes, some bookstores, stuff like that. That's our thing. That's what we're doing. That's what we're going to. It's really cool. We saw one today just on a whim when we were trying to get in to lunch or brunch at First Watch and we couldn't get in, but we did come across that, so we're gonna check it out. Might check out a couple bars tonight. I don't know, that'd be cool. Let's see where it goes. We're gonna do some shopping. I gotta pick up some shorts. We ain't going one of them right there. Yep. We have literally seen so many cool buildings and houses down here. Like for instance this. It's like a lit up arch, like dome thing. There's so many places we can literally occupy ourselves just by driving around and looking and exploring. Because we like to explore. But I think we're almost to the bookstore. So we're gonna check it out and see what it's like. That's kind of what we're doing. We're exploring little bookstores. Going to the bookstore. For the bookstore.
Good for you, not good for a regular person.
Where are you going? The hard way?
Yeah, right up there.
Saw that. I got a book. Marissa got a pouch holder and to put her Kindle in, right? And did you get a button? Or a couple buttons? Oh, you didn't get a button? We looked at a couple buttons, like they could go on it or whatever. And then now we're going overall pretty cool bookstore. Still doesn't beat the one that we go to in Cape. Does not beat the book rack. So if the book rack people's watching this, y'all guys are top so far. And you're probably gonna stay there. But in all honesty, still doesn't beat it out. Here does not beat out Cape Book Rack. So if you guys haven't been there, check it out. Book Rack, Cape Girardeau. Now we're going over to another bookstore and it is called Fine Indy or something like that. We're gonna go check it out. And told Marissa maybe we could find like a coffee shop or something, or coffee shop bookstore if they're open. The only thing that sucks is like most of the stuff you would wanna do closes about 4 o'clock. So we're trying to find the nightlife stuff now. So that's what we're doing. We're not real hungry. We had Cheesecake Factory for lunch and I had my cheesecake a while ago. I forgot to take a picture of it, but it was the Adams peanut butter something. It was amazing. Put me in a coma.
It was like a peanut butter cup in a cheesecake form.
Yeah, it was like a peanut butter cup in a cheesecake form. Marissa still has hers, so we will show you guys hers when she eats it. It is called the Celebration. And mine was smaller, so my piece was smaller, which was probably good because I would have been dead if I would have ate a bigger piece. And hers is like pretty big, so I figure hers is probably less rich than mine. Mine was so rich that they just, you know, they know you limit that. Like, if you eat more than this, you're gonna die. That's pretty much where we was at. In another bookstore, if I can bring the phone or the camera along, I will. Took this one along in the last one a little bit. Look at that rainbow. We're here. We're gonna check out this park first, I think. That music. It's getting kind of dark. It's like 8:22. They don't close till 10 o'clock. Like fish. Here, hold that.
Which is becoming less relevant, but I played it at a show like the day after, and I felt like a little, I was like, oh, maybe I should play this, but it went over well. I explained the joke up front. We're going down, and yeah, here we go. Free up your dreaming space, won't you make room for me? Give me a little taste of what's to be. As the sky turns yellow and the trees fall down.
What is up, guys? It is day three and we are heading, it's like 10:47. Just got done with my run. I accidentally went too far and ended up doing like almost 6 miles because I had to loop back by the bed and breakfast, and I ran too far, so like I needed to loop about a block and I went too far. I was filling my Cheerios today, I guess, and I almost went 6. So we're heading out now, going to the Holocaust Museum to check that out. Excited as heck about that. Won't believe what I saw today though. I decided to run downtown, so I went down and past Bush Stadium right in front of it and all that, and Cardinals mascot was driving the cart, the golf cart, down the street, just honking at everybody. Honked at me, gave me a thumbs up for running, thought it was cool, got a picture of him, gonna drop it in here right now. Just got out of the Holocaust Museum. It was awesome and fun in its own way, you know, because it's about the Holocaust, so. But it was really informative and cool, and we learned a lot. We both really enjoyed it, and we got to meet lady that gave us a lot of cool information, and then right near the end we got to meet a lady that her parents were Holocaust survivors. She told us a story about how they had got split up from their ghetto and were put in camps, and then after they were both liberated they didn't know if they were ever going to see each other again, pretty much. And when they both got liberated, they both somehow thought, I want to go back home, I want to see who all's there, and they went back home, and like they went there at the same time pretty much. Because they were already married, they were in our 20s, so they were around Marissa and I's age. And like, just off the chance, they went back home and they were together forever after. They settled in St. Louis after leaving from there, and they worked in garment factories, right? In garment factories. But while they were there, her mom actually like sewed and made dresses for the Nazis' wives, and her dad fixed and repaired the Nazis' uniforms. So it's really, really cool. We are heading to go do a little bit of shopping, and we've got to get gas, and we're going to go to a bookstore, and then we got Paramore concert tonight. That's what we're doing. So we just got out of the bookstore. It is called Half Price Books. I'll show you guys what it looks like here. This is it right here. I'll have to show you guys in a little bit. I got a big book that's like Sherlock Holmes. I got two Sherlock Holmes books, and Marissa got a Dolly Parton
word search.
So that's pretty cool. They have a lot of cool books. Yeah, it's something different. We don't have that. We haven't seen that around in our area. Bookstore still doesn't beat the book rack. Book rack's still on top, but
I don't think anything's going to beat the book rack.
Yeah, what she said. We don't think anything's going to beat the book rack, but it's still pretty cool. Now, we're on a time crunch, though, so we're going to go probably get some food and then do a little shopping and then Paramore in a little bit. We've got to be with our Uber about 6 o'clock. We gotta get to the Enterprise Center and all that stuff and get everything going for there.
The concert starts at 7, I believe, and I don't know when it ends, so I don't know when we'll get out of there. So the next place you guys will see us is either at the restaurant or shopping or after the concert. I don't know when I'm going to be able to pick up the camera or have it, so we'll see you guys when we see you.
So we just got done eating. We went to OB Clark's. It's a sports bar, and we found it on a last minute whim. We were over at Burlington Coat Factory, and we needed to eat real quick before the concert, so we did that. And I looked this up on Google, had great reviews, and I ordered the grilled chicken salad. The thing was literally bigger than my head. Marissa ordered a smaller salad with a tuna salad sandwich. The salad was about the size of her head. It was just like mine cut in half. And we ordered cheese bites before, cheddar cheese bites. And honestly, the service and food was all great all around. We didn't have any wait time at all. Like, our appetizer came out, and then we like took three bites of each of the cheese curds, and then boom, our food was there. It was awesome. 10 out of 10 recommend if you're ever in the area. It is called OB Clark's. Really great service, really great food. Now we're on a time crunch, hauling butt back, as you guys can see, to the Airbnb because we got to get ready for the concert, and our Uber's going to be there at 6, and it's like 5:21 right now, so we're just in a crunch. So got back from the concert. Let me get some better light going in here for us. We literally walked from the Enterprise Center to Soulard, where we're staying at. It was awesome walk. Wasn't too hot, nothing like that. Kind of in the areas I've been running in, but kind of not at the same time. We went some different areas. It's like midnight, 11:58 right now. Took us about 40 minutes to walk home, and then I ran over to the gas station, or walked over to the gas station, got a cheeseburger in case I wanted it later, and a diet soda. Now we're just gonna pretty much chillax and hang out for the rest of the night. We are gonna do some stuff tomorrow, but we go home tomorrow. We don't know what time yet. We do not want to go home. We're having fun, but hey, it is what it is. We'll be back in Bloomfield hopefully sometime tomorrow evening. So yeah, that's the scoop. They're called the Foals, F-O-A-L-S. They're from the UK, across the pond, as they say. Freaking awesome. And then the other band that opened for Paramore was
the Linda Lindas.
And literally, there's only one of them that's 18. All the rest are younger. There's like three or four girls.
Their drummer is 12 years old.
Their drummer is 12 years old, like Marissa just said, yeah. And then the girl on the guitar is like 16. The other ones, no, one's 15, one's 16. One's 18, something like that. You have to go check them out on Facebook, Instagram, all that. I'll try to link the bands and stuff below so you guys can check them out as well. But yeah, I can't even talk. I'm so tired. I think we're going to watch a movie or something. We're just hang out for a little bit. We're going to soak it in because it's the last night we're staying in the bed and breakfast. And it's really neat. If I remember, I'll give you guys a more in-depth tour because I did say something about doing that. And if not, you guys got to see pretty much the gist of it. It's really cool. Anyway, I'm going to hop off here. Spend time with Marissa, have some fun, and we'll see you guys in the next clip, probably tomorrow. Peace. We're heading out. Let's see ya. Last day. We're leaving the Airbnb now. Marissa's locking it up. 710 Ann Avenue. Great place. Peak Retreats is what it was called, I believe, right? Really awesome place. We got this whole building, as you guys saw. Two stories. And you guys saw the little tour. that I took you on. So now we're gonna lock this gate up for the last time. We have a front gate and a back gate. We just gotta go around front and put the keys in the lockbox for the cleaning crew to get in. And then we're off to do whatever we want to do in St. Louis today before we head back home. Did not run this morning because we had to get out quick. So I'm gonna run when we get home later. But yeah, we'll see you guys when we go do whatever we're doing.
You guys ever feel like you're forgetting something, but you check, double check, triple check? Yeah, that's how I'm feeling. Got the keys, gonna pull around front, put them in the lockbox, and head out and do some stuff in St. Louis. So Marissa, what do you rate this out of 10 out of 10, like, you know, 1 out of 10, 10 out of 10?
I rate the place definitely like a 9 out of 10. It was really awesome. Like, the bathroom was upstairs, so we had to go up the stairs, but hey, that's extra steps for me. Except for them steps will wear you out, for sure.
Yeah.
Those steps tired my legs out more than when I'm running.
I would probably rate it a 9 out of 10. And the location, I feel like, isn't really bad. But if I were to do this again, I think I would probably do something closer to, like, the Enterprise Center or something else.
Yeah, because we did walk home last night. And it was like 2 miles to get home, pretty much. And it was really cool walk and everything. But, you know, if you're not familiar with the area, you don't know nobody, there's always that risk. So you got to have your head on a swivel. Like, I would not be comfortable with her walking home by herself if she was by herself from the Enterprise Center. But I was with her, so I was okay. It was really fun. Saw some cool stuff. And, yeah, that's pretty neat. I wish I could have took pictures on the walk on the way home, but my phone storage was full. I fixed that this morning, so hopefully I can get some more cool pictures. I got a bunch of pictures to edit when we get back.
Scooter things.
Oh, yeah. We didn't get to ride those scooters. We were wanting to ride some of those scooters last night, but both of them that we were going to take from the Enterprise Center were on 30%. And then there were some others that were called Bird, and I think you had to, like, sign up to do that. So, yeah, we're going to drop off these keys, and we'll talk to you guys in a little bit, give you more reviews and stuff. But, yeah, got a bunch of footage and pictures and stuff to edit. Really great time. 10 out of 10 recommend coming down and staying in St. Louis and doing something cool, or coming up and staying in St. Louis, depending on where you are. But I'm gonna put these keys up. We'll see you guys at the next stop.
Okay, so the other day we were shopping, and I came back from coming out of a store, and we got ducked.
Look at that duck. It's got a freaking cupcake on top. Well, it is a cupcake, I think. Like, it's got a, what is that, whipped cream and a cherry on top? Yeah.
Yeah. But apparently whoever ducked us is a barber. And they left her, like, business card with her stuff.
Yeah, let's see if we can get up there so they can check it out.
Pretty cool.
You guys want to check them out? Anything that I have, that we have, that has, like, links or Instagram links, stuff like that, like the Airbnb, concert, bands, all that, I'm gonna try to link it in the description below so you guys can check them out. Like, what did you think about the two bands last night? We watched Linda Linda's. They opened up first. They're all pretty much under 18 except for one, right? I said that?
So. Yeah.
And they're all girls. They were pretty cool. And then the other band, the Foals, they came on. They're from the UK. They're older guys, and they're all guys. Freaking awesome. New favorite band. So, yeah.
It says it's from the Protagonist.
So we're heading to the Protagonist Cafe. It is a little bookstore and coffee shop. So we're gonna check that out. Went to the Protagonist bookstore. It's freaking awesome. They had a lot of crime books in the area that I was at. I didn't get a book, but we did get a freaking cool mug, a cool tumbler. I got a cool sticker for my laptop. Marissa got some cool stickers and a shirt. Freaking awesome place, awesome atmosphere. It's really neat. We sat outside, had coffee. Really awesome people working there. They recommended some other bookstores for us to check out, so we're gonna check that out. And yeah, overall, really enjoyed it. Now we're on to the next place.
Dude, I see that.
So we are at the Arch. Helicopter taking off. It was really cool. Wanted to go and like see it and get some pictures of it, stuff like that. So we hung out, kind of walked around the park. It was fun. Since we're kind of on a time crunch now, we're gonna go check out some more bookstores, check out downtown, and then we're just gonna kind of wing it from there and head home later. So yeah, and just having a grand old time. Like I said, we got lots of pictures and video to edit, so you guys are gonna have to stay tuned for that. Got out of eating at Twisted Ranch. Absolutely awesome food. The past few days we've eaten at quite a few places. I've gained quite a few pounds. Gonna have to work that off, but it was
starting route to Bloomfield.
It was well worth it.
We're head west on Maryland Plaza.
Getting in the car.
Left onto North Kings Highway Boulevard.
Getting in the car right now. We stopped by Insomnia Cookies earlier, I think I told you guys, and then we also stopped by Crave the Cup, which is cupcakes. We got that because today is my mom and dad's anniversary. We're gonna surprise them with cupcakes when we get back. Oh, the cupcakes look good. So yeah, back to the restaurant, the Twisted Ranch. 10 out of 10 recommend the food. I ordered the, let me look it up here real quick. I ordered the barbecue brisket. It's slow house smoked brisket topped with cheddar cheese, an onion ring, and barbecue ranch. They were out of what Marissa was initially gonna order because they had just had the lunch rush, so I believe they couldn't, they didn't have time to replenish their supplies because it just happened and we just beat it because it was pretty much just us and a few other couples in there. But great service, great food. The lady that served us, her name was Lex, and it was her first day. She was doing awesome. Left her a note on the receipt after we paid. Tell her thank you, and she's doing awesome. But yeah, I had a side salad with that. We both had the same thing. 10 out of 10 recommended. I'll drop the pictures in here somewhere. Like I said, I'm going to try to link all these restaurants and everything in the description down below for you guys to check out. Now, we're just heading out. We did go into Lululemon because I wanted to look at some running shorts. They didn't really have any colors I liked in stock. They had like orange. And they were only 5-inch. I do run in some 5-inch shorts, but I prefer 7-inch long shorts. That's just me. They're like $98. If I'm gonna spend that much money on a pair of shorts, I'm just going to get a color I like at least. And yeah, so I didn't get anything there. Saw a jacket I liked. It was like $140, which isn't bad, but I'm not gonna spend $140 on a jacket I'm gonna run in and get like messed up. So that's just me. Great place though, but yeah. Awesome time all together. We're pretty much heading home now. We had a great time. Can't wait to go on our next adventure. I think we have like wrestling coming up in August, and then we might be going. Yeah, we're not, like she said, we're not traveling for that one. It's just going to Cape. So that's our next like event that we're going to. We are looking at another concert. I think it's down in like Arkansas. Who is it? We're not sure if we're doing that one yet, but we're looking into it.
Skillet Theory of a Dead Man.
And then somebody else, I believe. But yeah, we're gonna head home. If we see something cool, I'll show you guys. But that's pretty much our trip so far. We really enjoyed ourselves, had a great time. It was good to get away from the hustle and bustle. honestly not ready to go back. We're not gonna miss the driving and the traffic up here at all, but we're definitely gonna miss the great times. And
honestly, it wasn't as bad as I thought it was going to be.
Yeah, it wasn't bad. Like the first night, or the second day when we got downtown, we ate downtown the first night, but the second day, it took us like 3 hours to find somewhere to park, and then the restaurant was so full, it was gonna be a 40 minute wait, and like we weren't already feeling good, we were gonna have to wait out in the heat, so we just ended up going to the Cheesecake Factory. But yeah, it was awesome overall. We had a great time and can't wait to do it again. So I'm gonna ask Marissa this question. I'm gonna pause this real quick so I don't get copyrighted. So out of the whole trip, let me get you in here real quick. Out of the whole trip, other than the concert, what was your favorite thing to do or what?
I think my favorite was the Holocaust Museum.
Yes, I have three favorites. The Holocaust Museum. I really enjoyed the Ferris wheel and Puck
Off. Yeah, the Ferris wheel was really fun. And Puck Puck Off.
Even though that was the day we were kind of blah. Marissa got really, really hot that day. It was ridiculously hot.
I think I gave myself a heat stroke.
Yeah, I think she literally either was at heat stroke, had one, or was very close to having one. It was so bad that when we got back to the Airbnb, she was in bed, had to get a towel to cool her face off, and she was sick as a dog.
And I was I had motion sickness. I couldn't stand up. I was dizzy. I couldn't, It was just crazy. I just couldn't do anything.
You never done that before.
I had the worst headache, and nothing I did even helped my headache. And I just felt hot. My whole body felt hot. I couldn't get comfortable. I couldn't get cooled off.
Yeah, you didn't sleep that well that night.
I didn't sleep well that night either.
I could tell because she woke up one time. I was down. I had the munchies. So I went downstairs, which I'll wake up in the middle of the night and be hungry sometimes, especially here lately with me running a lot. And I'll go down and just get something to eat. Well, I did that night. Usually she doesn't wake up. And that night, I heard her get up and heard her walk across the floor. And then she's like, where are you? I'm like, I'm down here getting a snacky snack. It was funny.
That's not what you told me.
Getting me something to eat? What did I say?
What are you doing?
Oh,
I was walking, and I was
I asked her what she was doing, because she wasn't supposed to be out of bed, because she wasn't feeling good. I'm like, what are you doing? Because I did not want her to fall down, because I thought she was going to pass out a couple times. It really worried me, and ever since she passed out before, I'm just mother hen in that way. And she does it to me about stuff, too. With my running. You saw I used to run way too much and made myself sick, so we're both pretty sure. Oh, that reminds me. I saw that guy. I'm pretty sure the guy was pulled over taking a pee. We were freaking walking back. We were walking back last night, remember? From the Paramore concert, and we get by this bar, and there's a black guy, and I can't say that. Cut that out. We're walking back from this bar, from the concert, and we're by this bar, and there's a big potted plant right out there, and this guy's talking to his friend. He's like, yo, man, something, something. His friends are talking back with her, and then we're almost up to the pot, and then he gets behind the pot, and he's looking back at us. I thought he was acting like he was hiding. Drunk as shit. Dude was drunk as shit, right? And I forgot what he said. He was on the other side, and we got by him, and he's just had his wiener out taking a piss, you know? And he's like, I can say that. He's like, I'm releasing, what did he say? I'm releasing toxins. That's what he says. I'm just releasing toxins, taking a whiz. So, what do you do? We just kept walking, and I'm good for you, dude. Good thing a cop's not coming by, because, yeah, that'd be bad. He got indecent exposure. Laughed my ass off after we got on past. I've had to pee bad before. I've had to pee, in the middle of the road on a gravel road before. You were there for that one. But, I've never, peed in front of somebody because I had to go so bad. But he was so far gone, he didn't even care. He did not care.
What was aggravating, though, is we almost got on a trolley bus.
Yeah.
We almost got on a trolley bus at the concert to try to, catch a ride so we didn't have to walk. And she's like, this is going to Molly's.
Are you guys going to Molly's? And we're like, no.
No, and she's like, okay, and then you can't get on the bus. And I was like, oh, okay. And then we ended up walking by Molly's.
She didn't tell us we couldn't get on the bus, did she? She was like, well,
yeah,
okay.
She's like, no.
Oh, yeah, not going.
The bus was going straight to Molly's.
You know where Molly's was?
We passed it.
Two blocks, maybe a block or two from our Airbnb.
Well, yeah.
Maybe 3 blocks. It wasn't no 2 miles. We walked 2 miles back. It was fun, But it was like,
it was not fun.
It wasn't fun to her because it was like midnight, kind of freaked her out, you know. Luckily, we weren't in too bad of neighborhoods. But, yeah, we pretty much just walked to City Home, walked through downtown, all the way from the Enterprise Center to Soulard, where our Airbnb was, and got a 2-mile walk in. We got some hill and steps in yesterday.
Yeah.
But, yeah, that was my favorite. The Ferris wheel, putt-putt golf, the Holocaust Museum, and I liked the mall, too. We went to the mall and shopped and stuff. That was fun.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, the mall was
We've done a lot of cool stuff. And the coffee shops. Like, all of it was
coffee
fun.
Shops.
Honestly, today the protagonist
/bookstores was
yeah, one of my favorites, and that
we
was
went
today.
To four different bookstores, I think.
We did go to four different bookstores. Where'd you like the vibe the most at? I like the protagonist coffee shop.
Yeah, the
at
protagonist
first
coffee
it was
shop.
Good.
I liked it. Their frappe was really good.
I tried it. I got a picture of it. I'll drop it in here.
I like that. The other one I liked was the Spine Indie Bookstore.
That was downtown, when it was raining, wasn't it?
Well, it's not necessarily downtown, but...
Well, it's like down in the older part.
Kind of. Like, we just kind of stumbled upon it, but... I liked that. I liked that bookstore, but we didn't really get to look at any books or things or whatever, but I liked the atmosphere of it.
That's where the boy was singing.
Yeah, that's
okay,
where
yeah.
The boy was singing.
You guys have seen that clip already. That was one. I was thinking of the one on downtown, like it was on the corner. What was it called?
Left book something.
Yeah, left something. I'll have to look it up. Yeah,
last
I got a mixed up.
Left book. Left mile book.
Yeah, something. I'll look it up. But yeah, oh yeah, I had fun. That was one of my favorite ones that we went to bookstore wise. We went there as a bookstore. But it was like 6 o'clock, 7 o'clock.
Well, I liked the bookstore that we went to today, the Subterranean.
Yeah, that was
books.
Cool.
I liked the layout of the store. And I probably could have found a book that I'd like to read. But, like, I'm kind of weird when I pick out books. Because, like, if it doesn't sound appealing to me, I won't read it. And sometimes I can go in a bookstore and just nothing sounds interesting to me. And that was kind of... That kind of was what happened with me today. I was like, eh. But I have those days. Some days, like, I can go into a bookstore and I can have my arms full. And then some days I'm like, nah.
And I like that bookstore, too.
Actually, correction, we went to 5.
Yeah, we went to half price books, half off books.
Because we went
books.
To half price books.
That was
in,
cool.
Like, a different... city, but area.
Borough?
Yeah.
I guess you'd say a name. Like, we were in Soulard is where we were. It was another borough / name.
Yeah, so...
And we ate over there at that one place, the bar, sports bar,
yeah.
O.B. Clark's, and it was really, really good.
Yeah, that was really good.
And, but back to that one bookstore that we went to that was called, Spine.
Spine... Indie Spine, or Spine Indie.
Yeah, Spine Indie. It was down by a park as well. What had happened was we were going there as a bookstore. It said they were open till 10. We wanted to get some coffee and do that. Ended up happening on some...
Saturday.
Yeah, we happened on some local artist. He was from St. Louis, right?
I don't know if he was from...
I'm not sure. I feel like his name says he was from St. Louis. But I'm not sure. Anyway, we happened to stumble upon an artist playing in there. There was like 3 playing. And we stumbled upon this guy. Got to meet him. Real cool guy. I got some footage of him, but I noticed my arms in the way and stuff. But like I said, I'll link all that in the area below. And the drinks were good. You had a hot...
I had a caramel macchiato. It was hot. Which I typically don't drink hot coffee. Like, I'm really weird about my coffee. But it was really good. I liked it. And then you had, like,
it's club soda with
flavoring.
And it was strawberry. I had that. She had it, too.
Yeah,
she liked
it. I enjoyed it.
I liked your, what do you call it? I'm just not used to it being hot either. So, like, I'm not a caramel macchiato hot person. I'm a cold caramel macchiato person. So, like, I like hot coffee. That's what I had today. Hot black coffee with Splenda at the Protagonist. And it was amazing. But, like, when it comes to stuff like that that's, like, kind of, like, chocolatey or sweet, I like it to be cold, if that makes sense. Are you the same way?
Yeah.
Like, I don't like it hot. Except for the Twix thing we get that you got from, that was in Dexter at Scooters. It kind of tastes like a Twix. Yes. That was good, hot.
I don't even know what that was.
I don't either. I remember that girl, like, she recommended it to you. Because I think you were, it's when you had the flu.
Yeah.
Or you didn't know you had the flu at the time. I remember that. That was last winter. That was horrible. But yeah, we're almost home. We're like in advance now. So we got like 15, 20 minutes until we get home, something like that. Overall, awesome weekend. My most favorite thing, though, was the concert. I have never been to a concert in my life. Paramore was my first concert. I'm already ready for my second. So, yeah, when we plan that out, we'll do that. But, yeah, like, our next event that we're going to, if we're not traveling anywhere crazy, but it's at Cape, and it is wrestling. So we're going to go to that. So we'll have to travel up to Cape. But it's not, like, way out of town, like, whatever.
Which is actually going to be really funny because, like, you watch wrestling, but you're, like,
I take that back. I'm into wrestling, but me and my dad were way into wrestling, which is funny. It's her and her dad were into wrestling when she was a kid.
My dad's not so much anymore.
Yeah.
But...
And that's what's weird. Like, I'm not so much anymore because my wrestlers were like Booker T, The Rock, Kane. What's the other one? I can't think of them all, but like, my favorite two wrestlers were Booker T and The Rock. Not even gonna lie. And now I'm not so much into wrestling as I was before because those wrestlers aren't there and her dad's not so much into it. But she's into wrestling really hardcore and my dad's into wrestling really hardcore.
Like hardcore.
Well, into it more than me. But it's funny. Yeah. So dad's still into it. I'm still into it, but not as much. She's still into it, but her dad's still into it, but not as much. So that's funny.
That's pretty funny. But we're all going as a family.
We even got mom going. Mom's going to wrestling, so I'm documenting the hell out of that. She's never been to wrestling. She's not into it either. She's more moral support. She's going for moral support, and it's going to be fun. So I'll document that. It'll be fun. And who knows? We might just go up there and spend the day and do some stuff before and whatever, because you got to have fun. You got to live life, man. Anyway, I'm going to hop off here. Storage is running out. Planning on going home, unpacking. Probably going to go on a run. Didn't get to run this morning and stuff. We wanted to do fun stuff and, you know, fit your exercise around your life. Remember, life comes first, family comes first, stuff like that, and then exercise around that. Don't make your exercise your main point. But I'm probably gonna do a jog because I'll run in the morning before work, and if I'm running tonight, I don't wanna do like, I'll either run hard tonight and easy in the morning, or easy tonight and hard in the morning. That's the plan, and yeah, we'll see you guys when I get to the house.